So welcome to the second edition of FICCI Fast Forward. It is our series to introduce to you key aspects of the economy from the lens and perspective of different leaders in their either space or in their sector. Today we have with us Mr. Sanjay Bhatia, who is the Managing Director of Hindustan Tinworks Limited. In addition, Mr. Bhatia is the President of the FICCI Confederation of Medium and Small and Micro Enterprises, FICCI CMSME. So a very warm welcome to you, Mr. Bhatia. You know, the pandemic has impacted the production and sales of different units in the country. So if I may begin with a just to get a sense of in your company and in your sector, is it back to the normal? We are in July, we'll be in, so what is the kind of productions and sales scenario in your sector and for example, your company?
Thank you very much for this. One, of course, is the, as far as the packaging sector where I am there, we are in, as you know, that we are in metal packaging and we are very closely working with the FMCG companies and a lot of food companies and even in non-food. So FMCG companies from that point of view. So we had, of course, initial up to, I would say that end of May, we had a lot of issues and a lot of problems of on, although we were allowed being in the essential commodities, one of the essential commodities, still we were allowed to run, but we lost production. We were in April and May, we were just working at 25-30% because the people were not there. But from June onwards now, we are virtually now in July. So we are back to, I would say, 80% of our production level. And but many of our customers who are in food industry and who were specially selling to the hotels, restaurants and catering businesses, since they are shut, so they have not reopened. So many of those companies, the processed food companies especially, who are selling these food products to for these restaurant and catering business and the hotels, so they are affected. So they are there. But generally, I would say that packaging industry as such is working now at 75%. I can say that that's in all the packaging field. So that is there, and but the challenges, of course, they still continue, and we are trying to work around them.
So how would you look at the MSME sector as a whole? You know, how was the impact of COVID on the MSME sector, and how are they coping, and what do you see going forward?
You see, this obviously, I mean, is something which one had never anticipated, that this is the kind of thing which is going to happen. I mean, there's a slowdown in the consumption, cash flows were affected, we were sitting on delayed receivables, we are sitting on heavy inventories. I mean, all these MSMEs I'm talking about, there had been disruption in the manufacturing supply chains. So it's virtually now, once we are out of, once the activities are resuming, I think there is, obviously you are in the process of resetting the business. So that's something is a big challenge. It's virtually with the acute cash crunch, which is there. So it's becoming difficult for the MSME sector in particular to really reset the business. And they are, I mean, really facing that challenge. Apart from the cash crunch, which is there, there's an impact, likely impact on the credit rating of the company, which banks really consider while giving the, while fixing the rate of interest. So, I mean, I would say that at least for MSME, it will take at least a year to really restart or go back to the normal. I mean, what they were doing in January, February, or let's say in the year 2019, to go to that level, it will really take that kind of a time. In addition to that, there are obviously the other issues which MSME is facing is the compliance to MHA guidelines, which are there, maintaining social distance, because they are working in not that kind of a large factories. They are a small factories, and they are finding it very, very tough to maintain social distance and to follow those kind of guidelines. Then loss of skilled labor is also there. The labor shortage is also another problem which MSME across the country are facing, because now, since there is a labor shortage, so whatever labor is available, that's being engaged by the large companies by paying higher wages and all those things. So MSME is not able to afford. So from that point of view, keeping in mind the lack of demand also, even after the unlock, I think cash crunch. So these are some of the major issues which MSME is facing.
So, you know, the government had launched the Atmanirbhar Bharat package there. And, you know, the first tranche, first time when they announced it, it focused on the migrant labor and the lower sections of society. But the second tranche had a big section on MSMEs. And in fact, they kept on adding to the MSME announcements as we got on. So what has the government done, and what is the impact on the ground as you see it?
Let me just say that government in this period has starting with RBI, they announced earlier loan moratorium and deferment of interest and installments and all. Starting from there, then this 3 lakh emergency credit line, which was part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat's total 20 lakh crore announcement. So 3 lakh crore was the emergency credit line which was there. And then the government also announced a 20,000 crore subordinate debt for stress MSME. And so on these two particularly, let me just focus that, because cash crunch is obviously the major issue which I just mentioned that the MSME is facing. To a certain extent, what I have been told that so far, the sanction, what has been made by the banks is about close to 1 lakh crore. And what the MSME has availed so far is 50,000 crore. So that is what, out of 3 lakh crore, is just, it happened that. Because you see, although it's a collateral free, but that is only up to 5 crores. And that too, the loan outstanding on 29th of February. Based on that, maximum 20% of that. So if on that particular day, I don't have a loan of 5 crore, I just have my outstanding is 2 crore. So I will only get 20% of 2 crore. So the maximum ceiling is 5 crore. But because of this, the setback what the MSME has received, the fund requirement, cash requirement is much, much higher than what it is there. Secondly, there are many MSMEs who were not availing bank loans at all, who were working with their own funds. So they will not get anything. So I think from that point of view, the scheme requires some more modification, I would just say that, so that these kind of units also come under the purview of that. And thirdly, now with the change in the definition and more units will come in the MSME. So maybe that, but here also the condition was that maximum turnover is 100 crore, only then you can get. So from that point of view, it's a scheme which is good, but it's a restricted scheme. I mean, 100 crore maximum turnover, then loan standing on 29th of February, 20% of that, collateral free up to that. So these are some within those restrictions, I think, which is there. So from that point of view, I mean, that is why the offtake is not that much. So it is just 50,000 crore companies have taken.
So I think what you are really saying is that while the scheme is good, a lot of MSMEs who are not in the financial space, who have not taken loans, et cetera, and don't have credit outstanding, possibly may not benefit from it. And there is a need to look at this these firms also. Now, the government has also recently announced the extension of the payment of employee provident fund and employer's contribution to units. So how does that impact the sector, and what do you think about it?
Before I just answer your question, I would just like to add that I would like to draw attention to the FICCI responsibility strategy to COVID-19, a paper which was presented to government by FICCI, where we had suggested interest-free, collateral-free loan. So if, because you see, if the unit is not able to work, I mean, the companies are hesitant also to take more loan as they have to pay it back after a year. So, I mean, there's a fear that whether they take the loan. So if it is, if it had been interest free, there would have been more people really, really taking it. Now going.
Let's continue this discussion on the finance and the interest thing a bit more. So some states, I think Karnataka and Gujarat and maybe Haryana, have actually done some interest subvention. But this has not happened pan-India. And what are the best practices and what could other state governments actually do to support the MSME, you know, in terms of electricity charges, you know, rentals and all of that? So is there an agenda there?
I think that that would be very helpful because these are fixed costs which any company and any MSME unit is paying. What Haryana has done, which I remember, is that they have given the loan only for the wages. The whatever wages you have paid, so only for that. So it's not that something interest-free they have given for various other things. I mean, fixed charges only up to, initially only up to 10,000 rupees. They said that we'll just waive it. But then some other state governments have done on the fixed charges. But I think there is a, obviously there's a need to really help the industry because MSME is, they look towards the state government for a lot of help. I think this would be really helpful there in case this comes up.
Okay, so we can go back to the Provident Fund question that I had asked you and what the government has done.
Again, Provident Fund, I mean, again, it's a good scheme. Let me put it this way. But that's a restricted scheme again. Saying that only up to 15,000 rupees, less than 15,000 rupees salary, one. Second is more than 90% of the employees should be less than 15,000 rupees. Only then this this is available. So this will help some of the micro units, absolutely, but it will not help across all the MSMEs. So from that point of view, it's a restricted scheme. But yes, whatever is comes to, I mean, let's say even if part of the big chunk of the MSME, if they get it, that would be very good. So we just welcome it. And similarly, ESI also, they gave some extension in the installments and all. So that is there. So I think these things do help because where the employer's contribution is, in this case, employer and employee, both contribution is given by the government for 3 months, then extended by another 3 months. But again, as I said, the restriction is there that 15,000 rupees salary and the unit should have more than 90% of the employees should be less than 15,000.
So, you know, you mentioned when you were discussing earlier, you'd mentioned that people are avoiding buying except essentials and there's a lack of demand. Declining demand is also a great concern for MSMEs. So, what do you suggest that we could do to increase demand? And, you know, because all the interventions are supply side interventions so far, what could be done for demand?
Well, it's that's something very important because whatever cash you give me, whatever things if you give me to reset my business and restart it, if the demand is not there, I will not be running my business. So that's something is very, very important. So I would say that the government again can take some measures, as I just mentioned on the hotels, restaurant and hospitality business, as we call it. So what relaxations really with all the conditions, whatever the conditions are there, if those can be really opened up gradually, the catering businesses and all, so that would really help the increase in demand. But apart from that, I think one is the universal basic income scheme. If the government can look at announcing that. So then the cash transfers to daily wage earners, farmers, migrant workers, if that can also continue to take place. Impetus on the infrastructure or housing, auto sectors. So I think these are few things which are there. Maybe GST rate, if they are rationalized for some time. So they, or income tax rates are rationalized, personal income tax rates are rationalized. So these things will put more cash into the hands of people and would certainly increase the demand.
So, you know, we were talking to somebody from a state government and he had an actual observation to make that, you know, while their expenditure has doubled, their revenues have halved. So, you know, if you look at the position of the central government or the state governments, in that context, what could be done really to actually spur demand? You talked of infrastructure, right? You know, fast forwarding infrastructure or fast forwarding other things on the housing.
Housing.
In the Atmanirbhar package, they've announced 1 lakh crore for agriculture infrastructure. They have addressed, they talked about the housing. So what could some of these measures be that could increase demand, which is not hitting the financial revenues of the state or the center?
Well, you see, you have to put in the cash into the market. That has to happen. That is the only thing which will increase demand, because you see, with all this gap which has come into to 3 months gap, which is there, that has hit everyone's pocket. So everyone is really adversely affected. So, I mean, government has to really increase their expenditure on various things. So they, even if they have to borrow something, or even if at the cost of fiscal deficit, as we call it. So maybe I think they have to take bold step, as we call them, and help the economy, pump in that money into the economy, and so that this can come back. The economy starts running. It's important. I mean, for me also even in our businesses, to reset the businesses, we have to do all that. So it is true for the economy also. I mean, unless and until that happens.
So I think, you know, you said this. What would you advise micro and medium and small enterprises? What are the managerial steps and managing their business? What are the key 3 or 4 things that they should focus on to actually survive, then revive and thrive going forward?
You see, COVID 19 has really taught us a lot of things, and to prepare for these kind of challenges also in future. But obviously, this is going to stay with us, these kind of challenges, for at least for a year, 2 or 3, I don't know. But this is going to stay, these challenges are going to stay. So one has to learn to run the factories while meeting the guidelines, hygiene guidelines and all that. I think one is that very important, that one has to see how social distancing and the wearing of mask or hygiene, whatever, they have to take the steps so that there's no more spread of this disease. So that's something which is important that has to be done. The other is that we have now learned to work from home and to see that how we can manage while sitting at home. So those are the use of digital technology and the new technologies or automation. I think these are the things which any MSME also has to look at, in case they have to keep supporting the large units to run them. Then there would be, I would say that one has to keep his eyes and ears open on the new opportunities which are coming due to the stand taken by many countries against China. So whatever new opportunities are coming into India or neighboring countries, for that matter, they can do export also. So that's something which is which they have to focus. Last thing which I would say is that which is important in the packaging industry in particular. We have seen many other industries also, they depend on China for their supply chain requirements. A lot of parts are coming from there, a lot of components, machinery, these things are coming from there. So there is a need. I would strongly recommend that government should create some sort of a soft loan fund scheme or something like that, which would be focused on the import replenishment. I mean, there would be import substitution scheme. So which I would, let's say, suppose my company is importing today, let's say, a goods worth 50 crores. And if I set up a unit and I start making them in India, but the payback for these are very long. It's not that 3-4 years it will be payback. It would be 10 years payback. So there, in case 10 years, some soft loan can be given as a technology development fund or a import substitution fund or maybe export push fund. So that is something which would really help the MSME to avail those opportunities and do it. I think that's what I feel.
So, you know, finally, how do you see, you know, the government has revised the definition of MSMEs. So how do you actually see this benefiting the MSMEs after the announcement of this definition, and how will it impact the Indian structure of the Indian economy going forward?
Well, I think with the definition, both turnover and investment based, what they have done now, although from FICCI, we had been, I mean, I recall for last 5-7 years, we had been pushing on the turnover based definition. But finally, that has happened. We welcome it. Although it's still a qualifying investment and turnover both. So, but with this, we would see that there would be many more units which will come under the ambit, because the export turnover is not taken into consideration. And as per our understanding, the investment would be taken as per the guidelines which have been issued, would be the depreciated value of the asset, because this is started now from 1st of July. So from that point of view, many more units will come under the ambit of MSME. So there would be more uptake of the schemes which are there, which are announced post-COVID and which were there pre-COVID also. So pre-COVID also, there are many schemes which had been there announced by the government. But what is lacking is the awareness of the scheme. So now I think the units which would be coming into, mostly the units come into the medium category, not in the small category, but into the medium category. So medium category, more units will come. So they would be having a sort of a potential to grow to the large units. So they would be really taking benefit of all that. And like interest subvention or the capital goods schemes or whatever other schemes, there are many other schemes which are there. So that would help in uptake of the schemes and the with the awareness, more awareness, I think they can really grow and the economy should grow.
So, well, thank you very much for that, Mr. Bhatia. So, you know, explaining the government programs under the Atmanirbhar Bharat scheme, the changing of the definition, the need to find a financing mechanism for those outside of the ambit, and getting the best practices in the different state governments replicated across the country, so that we can focus on the growth and development of the MSME, and also for your suggestions for how and what managers in the MSME units need to do in the current times. Are they meeting guidelines, conserving cash, developing markets, doing import substitution, and really sharing with us that the future of the MSME sector is bright, and that we all need to work together to make Bharat Atmanirbhar. So thank you very much for your time today. Thank you.